one of the things that I would bet my money on rather is looking at energy conservation and improvements in energy efficiency.
In my opinion, wind energy looks good because it is clean and effective and it doesn't have the dangers of like nuclear energy.
So I think people should start working on solar energy. That would be my solution to the energy problem. I think we need to create awareness about these issues more so that people try to understand that how important it is that we need to find alternative sources of energy, because one day or the other, everybody knows these fossil fuels are not going to last.
I feel it's a moral obligation for us to launch some incredible and powerful energy XPRIZEs. Prizes for alternative energy generation, for next generation renewable microrefineries, for energy storage, for conservative energy usage. People ask, how do we come up with the XPRIZE concepts? Well, there are three primary ways. First, we go out to the global thought leaders, the mavericks, the people who have the same passion for this that I had for opening the space frontier. Second, we get interest from the general public. The notion is that someone out there has a crystal clear, powerful idea that can become an XPRIZE. And third, with our partnership with MIT, the XPRIZE lab at MIT.
Everyone needs to change their lives in some way. I've been already testing, sort of experimenting with my own life. I'm finding that my own life is improving as I'm making the changes that you would hope everyone will adopt. So I think it's definitely possible. I don't think we have a huge amount of time to wait, but I think the general public has that message now that, you know, it's something of a very important issue. And so I think we just need to sort of bite the bullet and do it. And the take-home message is we probably need every renewable energy technology we have, and we need to go full tilt on all of them.
One key observation is that we have 10,000 times more sunlight than we need. In other words, if we captured one part in 10,000 of the sunlight that falls on the Earth, we could meet 100%, which is 10 to the 13th watts, of the energy that we consume worldwide.
And so many of the solutions to energy problems are not necessarily solutions to the carbon dioxide problem, as long as we keep loading the atmosphere with carbon dioxide. And some people think we already have too much up there, so we need to sequester it.
We intend to deploy those methods solving energy and environmental problems. We encourage small-scale, decentralized, distributed methodologies, and we look forward to being the partners of every successful entrant in this room.
Remember, the day before something is truly a breakthrough, it's a crazy idea. So, we'd like to know what your crazy ideas are in the energy environment space. And we're looking for a 2-minute XPRIZE concept up on a YouTube video. This is being deployed on the front page of YouTube in partnership with them, funded by Prize Capital. On November 15th, we're going to pick the top three ideas and put it out for world vote. And that winner will be awarded $25,000.
I was thinking, sitting up in the stands, thinking about what different ideas I have, but there's really so many ways to approach the problem. I'm a poor graduate student, and the dollar sign does affect decisions, yes.
The Crazy Green Idea Contest is a crazy idea, but it could have some really potential and far-reaching impacts, in the sense that there's a lot of young, talented people who are using media to put their ideas and their pitches out there. And I think YouTube has already revolutionized the media world, but XPRIZE has revolutionized the innovation world and the science and engineering world. So I think bringing those two together is a good synergy of the two.